Welcome to this SFTP Gateway tutorial by Thorn Technologies. My name is Chris, and today I'm going to show you how to get started using SFTP Gateway on the Google Cloud Platform. To get started, go to the Google Cloud Platform Marketplace and search for SFTP Gateway. Find the listing by Thorn Technologies, and this will bring you to the product overview page. From here, you can click Launch, and this will take you to the SFTP Gateway Deployment Wizard. Give your deployment a unique name. I'm going to name mine Chris SFTP GW Demo. Select a zone in which you would like to deploy your VM. For the machine type, choose a general purpose type that fits your needs. For me, I'm going to choose an E2 medium for the purposes of this video. For the boot disk, I'm using an SSD persistent disk with 30 gigabytes of space. Under the firewall settings, I'm going to tick the checkboxes for port 2222, HTTP, and HTTPS. For the source IP range on port 22, you're going to use 0.0.0.0/0. This will allow traffic to port 22 from any IP address. Later on, there will be a way to restrict access to port 22 through the SFTP Gateway admin web interface. These other three ports are used for SFTP Gateway administration and should be locked down to your workstation's public IP. To find your public IP address, you can go to checkip.dyndns.org, copy your IP address, then paste it into port 2222, which is used for SSH, and add /32 to turn this into an IP range. Then, just do the same for HTTP and HTTPS. Then, tick the checkbox accepting the terms of service and hit deploy. It may take a few minutes for your SFTP Gateway server to deploy. Once the deployment is complete, you can find a link to your server over here on the right. Click this. This will take you to your server details page. From here, you can scroll down to network interface and find the external IP address. Copy that and open this in a new tab. This will take you to the SFTP Gateway landing page. However, since SFTP Gateway uses a self-signed certificate, you'll have to bypass this SSL warning. Just click Advanced and proceed to the IP address. This will bring you to the first launch experience for SFTP Gateway, where you can create your first admin user. Just give it a name and then a password that meets complexity requirements. Then click Create. This will create the user, and then you can sign in with that user. When you first sign into SFTP Gateway, you will see this message asking you to configure a default storage. This is required because SFTP Gateway relies on the Google Cloud Storage as the SFTP user's underlying file system. Just click OK to dismiss this dialog box, and you will be on an Add Google Cloud Connection Settings page. This is automatically populated with the name Default Storage. You can then either give this a Google Cloud Storage bucket that already exists, or you can create a new one from here. I'm going to use the bucket Chris SFTP Gateway Demo. I'm also going to use a service account key that I've already previously created. To learn more about service account keys, you can click this link or view the video linked in the card above. Then just click Save, and this will save the default cloud storage. From here, we can go over to create a user. Add a user, give it a name. I'm going to name mine Bob Test, and then you can upload an SSH key. You have a couple options here. You can either upload an existing key or have SFTP Gateway generate a new key, and this will save the public key and download the private key. For now, I'm just going to name mine Bob Test and generate a new key. Then click Add. Another option you have is to go into Advanced and give the user a password. From here, you can also see that this is where we can restrict IP addresses for this specific user. More on that in an upcoming video. For now, I'm going to save this user. Now, If I head over to FileZilla, I can make this connection for Bob Tess by selecting the SFTP protocol using my server's public IP, and then going to key file logon type, entering the user's name, and then browsing to the user's key that I just downloaded. Now I can just hit connect. Since this is my first time connecting to the VM with this user, I will get this known host keys warning, and I'm just going to accept it. Now, you'll see that this user is connected to the server, and I can upload a file. Once the file finishes uploading, I can go back to the Google Cloud Console and look in this bucket and see that the user's file appears here.
That's all for this video. If you found this helpful, please give it a like and consider subscribing and ringing the notification bell to stay up to date on all of our SFTP Gateway videos and tutorials. You can also check out our knowledge base at help.thorntech.com or contact us at support@thorntech.com. And follow us on Twitter @thorntech for more news and updates.